Hello, and welcome to this update video for VMware Tanzu Application Platform version 1.2. The first thing that we're going to look at here is our TAP GUI, and we've got our organization catalog here. And what we've done is we've already deployed an instance of Tanzu Java Web App here. So if we go into our runtime resources and we select the kind as pod, you can see that we have our build cluster listed currently. If I go ahead and access our application, you can see this is on the staging cluster, and this one is on the live cluster. Whenever we go back into our runtime resource viewer, what we'll see is those will now show up inside of our viewer here. So if we choose our pod, you can see that we have our staging and live application instances here as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to update our application, because at the minute, you'll remember it says greetings from TAP 1.2 in both staging and live. And what we're going to do is watch it go through the supply chain here. And the supply chain is end-to-end, completely automated using GitOps and Git principles. So we've got our application here, and you can see it says greetings from TAP 1.2. So we'll change that to Tanzu Application Platform. And we'll do that also for the test, as well as the application itself, because if it doesn't pass the tests, it won't get through our testing pipeline because it'll be rejected. So we've changed our application. Let's go ahead and commit that to the repository. And that has now been pushed to our Git repo. So if we go back in here and we have a look at our application repo, you can see it says 15 seconds ago, we made a change. So in our supply chain, what we'll notice now is the source provider has picked up the change, happened a few seconds ago, and the SHA for that commit is 535D. So if we have a look here, you can see 535D. So it's picked up the change that we made, and it's pushing that change through the supply chain. So currently you can see it's running through the source tester. You can see that we've already deployed this before, and this is the new instance that's currently being tested. So if I click on this, we can view the logs that are applicable for that particular testing run. Once the source tester step is done, it'll hand off that commit to the source scanner, and then Grype will take that source code, look for any built jar or WAR files inside of it, because we're running a Java application here, and see if there are any vulnerabilities bundled. It doesn't currently check the pom.xml, so it's not going to build out the dependency tree and check the dependencies for vulnerabilities. But that's just a limitation of the Grype scanner. So you can see it's now doing its source code scan. The source code scan completed successfully. You can see that we have no CVEs currently listed. That's always nice. And then it pushed those changes onto our image builder. So it's passed in the branch that the commit was made on, as well as the commit SHA to our image builder. The image builder is going to use cloud native Buildpacks and analyze the source code and figure out what is the best way to build this application. So as you can see, if we look at a previous run here, we can see here are the build logs of that previous run. We can have a look through it if we're trying to debug anything, if there was a build failure or what have you, or we just have the information there for reference in case we wanted to see what happened during the build. We'll see the same thing for build number two once it actually completes its build. Okay, we can see that the image builder has now finished successfully. So it'll take the image that is built, push that up to our pre-designated repository, and then pass that into our image scanner. In this case, we're using an image scanner called Snyk, which is a new integration that we have in TAP 1.2. And you can see that it's currently running. It will show cached results from the previous scan as well. So if there were any vulnerabilities found in previous scans or that particular package is used across multiple applications, we'll see that updated here as well. So you can see the Snyk scan finished successfully. We saw 81 vulnerabilities. And if we go into our severities here, we can filter by severity, medium or low, whatever we're interested in. We can also change the number of rows that are available. So we can see what vulnerabilities exactly affect that application. That application now has passed through because it didn't have any high or critical vulnerabilities. So it passes through our pipeline as it adheres to our scan policy. You can see then the config writer has completed as well. The config writer will then push this commit to our GitOps repo for Tanzu Application Platform. So if we look at view approvals here and we approve the request, it'll open up our GitOps repo for this particular application. You can see that it says it wants to commit a merge from this branch that was generated just for this commit into our staging environment. So we'll go ahead and commit that, and we can delete our old branch now that we don't need it. And if we go into our code into staging, you can see that this was updated 11 seconds ago. Now, if we go back into our TAP supply chain here, and we have a look at our two deliveries, you can see that we have a delivery for a staging cluster and a delivery for our live cluster. That's what we saw running at the minute where it says, hello from TAP 1.2. Now what we're expecting to see is once FluxCD, which is the underlying Git watcher that we use for Tanzu Application Platform, notices a change in that GitOps repo on the staging branch, it'll pull down that change and then push it into the staging cluster. So you can see it's now successfully noticed that there was a change. It's passed in again the staging commit SHA. So we can see here 4CA5B2. If we have a look at this, 4CA5B2, and it says it was delivered onto the staging cluster. So let's have a look at our staging cluster, and you can see that the application has been updated and now matches what we have in our code. Just to show you one final bit, it still says TAP 1.2 on our live cluster here. That's because we haven't told TAP that it's safe to deploy this into the live cluster. So let's go back into our GitOps repo. We'll go to pull requests. We'll open a new pull request. We'll tell it to merge from staging into main. You can see that it's going to change the image that's being deployed. We'll create the pull request, go ahead, and once we've reviewed and we're happy, we'll merge that pull request into main. So if we go back to our code here and we look at the main branch, you can see that the change was just now and it is 4AE3D. So if we go back into our supply chain here and we have a look at this, this will automatically notice that change and we'll see the same commit SHA show up here. You can see that it has successfully noticed the change and that it has pulled that main 4AE3D commit that we saw in our GitOps repo. And if we have a look at the delivery here, it hasn't quite rolled it out yet, but if we give it a second, it'll roll out successfully and then we'll check the live cluster as well to make sure that it represents the new version of the application. So there it is, it's successfully deployed. If we go back to the live version of our application here and we refresh, you can see it now says, greetings from Tanzu Application Platform. So end-to-end, completely automated with manual approvals for GitOps if you want them, and the developer never has to interact with any Tanzu CLI or anything like that. All they can do is work on their code, they commit their code to Git as they normally would, and as soon as it's committed to Git, it runs back through the pipeline, and then it's up to the ops teams to deploy that or gate that and allow that into production. So that was a quick update on TAP 1.2, some of the new features that we have. So we've got multi-cluster visibility in the supply chain here. We have a GitOps approach with PR approval for rolling out to production. We have a new Snyk image scanner as well, which is currently in beta. And additionally, you can now view the logs of your source tester and your image builder as well. For more information on Tanzu Application Platform, please visit tanzu.vmware.com.